Flowers, don't worry. Why should you? Verse 28, why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They don't toil or spin. Yet I say to you that even Solomon in all of his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Hey, even Solomon in his royal robes, surrounded by his lavish furniture encrusted in gold, was not as beautiful as a simple flower. And he probably picked one up, one of the wildflowers growing there in Galilee. Look at the beauty of this flower. They don't worry. They don't stress out. And yet we'll be so concerned about what we're going to wear. You know, is this in style? Does this look good? Do I look fat in this? And sadly, that's what I said to my wife this morning, all three of those things. No, I didn't. But, you know, we're so concerned about our appearance. We're in a culture that is obsessed with appearance. And now we've taken this into changing our bodies with plastic surgery. And billions of dollars are spent every year. People want to look like someone else. You know, they want to look like a movie star. Sometimes I'm not sure what they're trying to look like, and I'm not sure what they do look like, but they change their appearance dramatically. I read an interesting article about this in the paper. The title of the article was about people that are obsessed with their appearance, and the title actually was Beauty Junkies Examining a Society Obsessed with Appearance. And the author of the article interviewed a surgeon, plastic surgeon from L.A. And this doctor said, you know, the women in Los Angeles live in a world that's all about looks. And once these begin to fade and their husbands trade them in for younger women, things get especially ugly. He says it gets desperate on a deeply metaphysical level. He says they wake up and realize they're nothing but a shell of a skin. They didn't do anything on the inside. And I don't care how many yoga classes you go to, you won't be able to cope. You're not equipped and you don't know why, end quote. I thought that was pretty insightful. You know, they've worked on the outside, but they've done nothing for the inside. And that's what Jesus is saying. And that's the emphasis of the Bible. The Bible is not saying, don't be attractive. It's saying, don't be obsessed with your looks. Frankly, some people ought to think a little bit more about their looks. There is a place for that too. You can go too far either way, can't you? Well, I just don't care. Well, we have to look at you. We do. Nothing wrong with a girl wanting to look cute. Nothing wrong with a guy wanting to look good. Those are not sinful things. But if that becomes more important to you than your spiritual life, and you spend all your time in the outward and completely neglect the inward, then your life is out of balance. That's what this is saying. I mean, the Bible even says to girls in 1 Peter 3, what matters is not your outward appearance, the styling of your hair, the jewelry you wear, the cut of your clothes, but your inner disposition. Cultivate inner beauty, the gentle, gracious kind that God delights in. See, so why is that important? Because one day this body will be gone, but the soul will live forever. It was Irma Bombeck who once said, quote, sooner or later, dust wins. But the real you and me will live on. So if the greater thing is in his control, I can leave the lesser to him as well. Don't stress out about that stuff.